This is Shonda, also known as Lusty. You are hanging out with me on LustyTalk.com. Today, I'm going to talk to you about something that's very important, a subject that I've been wanting to talk about for the longest, but I just didn't know how to talk about it without people thinking that I was so lame. But now, I don't care. And I am going to talk about it right now here on LustyTalk.com. This world is ever so changing. And I know that you probably notice that in your everyday life, that things are not the same anymore. In this world, we have senseless crimes every day. Every day that we wake up, there's always something on the news that you hear. But today is something that is touch close to home in this reality world. A senseless crime that really, it didn't need to happen. One of our reality people, one of our reality own, who was a contestant on Megan Wants a Millionaire, Ryan Jenkins is charged with killing his ex-wife. Wife, Jasmine, by a senseless crime, which is gruesome, by removing her teeth and her fingers. Now, we had so many senseless crimes with Steve McNair and his mistress, you know, shooting him. And sometimes you're thinking, what is going on in their freaking heads? Why are they doing this? Why? And sometimes we have to ask ourselves, do we really know the people that we're working with? Do we really know the people that we are sleeping with? Do we really know the person that we are talking to on an everyday basis? But you can't live your life just on pins and needles. You know, I don't think God would want us to do that. But this guy is one. This guy was a contestant on Megan Wants a Millionaire, also in the I Love Money 3. And actually, it sounds like he, from what I read, that he did very well, that he was boasting about winning $250,000 on I Love Money 3. Are saying that it's VH1 or 51 Minds Entertainment fault. You know, it's not their fault at all. Extensive medical history on you. They do extensive psychological evaluation on you. They also do extensive credit check, background check. I mean, the whole works, where they just strip you until you're nothing, until you're bare, so they can get some things out of you to build a character. But what I don't understand is that, you know, I mean, I've been in this man's shoes where, you know, you do take a psychological evaluation, but also you talk to the doctor too. And then, you know, you answer 500 questions, you know, have you ever had killing thoughts? Have you ever, you know, want to kill someone? And, you know, they kind of switch it in this in wordage, but it's the same question that they asked you, but it's, they're asking you in a different way, in a different light, just to see if you'll slip up. But, I mean, can they really prove just by a questionnaire that this man was psycho, that he was crazy? also another topic that I also want to talk about too is that, you know, with Megan wanting a millionaire, you know, girl, let me tell you something. I've been down that road. And, you know, of course, you know, we always want nice things and we want someone that has money that's going to take care of us. But sometimes I often ask myself this question. Do I really want to dance with the devil? Do I really want to dance with the devil? Do I really want to give my soul to someone just because they might have something that I want? And I don't want to go down that road. Because, you know, Megan, and I just hate that this happened to this wonderful female, Jasmine, beautiful girl. I hate that happened to her, and my heart goes out to her and her family. But I tell you one thing, Megan should look at this situation and say, my God, thank you, Jesus, that this wasn't me. And this world is ever so changing. And it's different. We have so much pressures of this in this world. We got people who cannot handle pressure. We got people who are losing their jobs. We got people who are killing each other for a computer, or just so that they have something that they want because they don't have it. We got people who are violence and killing, these senseless crimes and stealing from each other. And for what? Just because you lost your job, just because you can't handle something right now, and you know you can't pay your bills, and one thing leads to another, and it's building, it's building, it's building, and you're just right on that edge where you just want to explode, and you got to just stop, just remove yourself from a situation that you're thinking that you're about to snap the fuck off. Just remove yourself from that situation and just let it go. Because I'm going to tell you something. I'm pretty sure this man, Ryan Jenkins, a contestant on Megan Wants a Millionaire, wasn't thinking that he was going to snap the fuck off. But now he has dug himself deeper, where he's never going to be able to have a normal, rich life like he used to. He had everything. From what I am reading, he had everything. But now it's going to be gone. They will catch him. They will catch him.